Oh shit, what's up y'all? Another edition of a Guilty Gear Accent Core Plus R tournament that we didn't think was gonna happen because holy shit, how many people actually signed up for this? This is crazy. I can't believe how many people are playing Guilty Gear right now. It's awesome. But we have another tournament. It's gonna be me on the mic along with Melty God and also Snores Extraordinaire Makoto Fox.
You want to say snores because I'd sleep in the call at like 4 a.m. and you guys are watching
the
anime.
I was talking about this last night. You have peak snores. Your snores are phenomenal.
What do you mean by peak?
Like your snores are incredible. They're really good.
how do you snore good? I don't get that.
I don't know. Like I don't have a snore. My snore is like no one knows when I'm sleeping. Everybody knows when you're sleeping. So we all go like, okay, everybody be quiet. Tuck them in. All right. All right. You know what people do? You know what people do in my house? They bust in the door and they're like, hey, what's up? And I'm like, all right.
All right, I'm awake. Screw it. Yeah, I hate that. But what up, everybody? We actually knew we were going to do another one of these before the tournament even finished last week because there was a Match Arena goal and we met that.
And then there was a Mother Match Arena goal and then we met that. And then there was another Match Arena goal and then we met that.
Wait. What was the one after the 25v25?
No, wasn't there? There was like a 1,000 one and then the 25v25.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah. That's what it was. Oof, damn, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Whew. So, yeah, once again, thank you everyone for using the Match Arena codes, for putting in, helping the players have a little bit more incentive to, you know, be like, oh, hey, if I make top 8, I get this much money. Then they're like, hey, I get top 3, I get this much money. So it's always nice to have that little extra thing there while you're playing a game.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, unfortunately, this is probably like the last weekend that we'll get to do this for the unseeable future. But at least we got to see what this would feel like in terms of like, you know, getting to be involved with the beta and having everybody, you know, try it out all together and seeing how many people are willing to jump into a game. Maybe half because they were interested in the game before or maybe half just because they wanted to play a game with GGPO or rollback, I should say. And that's like, that's so crazy. I think like just the last month in terms of people showing like how much they really appreciate or how much like good netcode does for your game is like, I think it's like, it's proven now. You can't dispute it like as anybody.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are, they were kind of on the fence, like, is rollback really that important? Like, we have netcode that works just fine. Why do we need to fight for rollback so badly? Like, I understand the always yelling for rollback is kind of annoying. I get that.
Yeah, exactly.
But you have to understand what this means. Like, I've been able to play plus R. For the most part, I've only had maybe 2 bad matches out of the last, like, week and a half. And I've played minimum 100 games over the course of like the week and a half. So that lets you know I can do almost everything that I normally want to do outside of like not having practice, but you can do pretty much everything. It's like, oh, you have 250 ping? It's fine. You'd be able to play it. Like as soon as you load in, you're like, oh, this doesn't feel that bad. Then you play and you're just like, wait, this is 250 ping MS? That's crazy.
I was talking about this on my stream on Wednesday, but like the implementation of, or like just say netcode in general that is able to be used across the United States just does so much for the competitive community in a way that you cannot comprehend. Like it's like you think about like how every other esport does this in terms of like doing online matches first. Like they do like usually online tournaments or online qualifiers and then having them show up to LANs afterwards. I'm not saying that that should be a replacement for what our tournaments normally are. I'm saying that that is now a new avenue for people that wasn't available to them before. So like people who don't have the means to go out to every single tournament have the means to go do net play tournaments and then get flown out. Like stuff like that is possible now. And it makes sense. And it's in a competitive environment instead of it just being this sort of like token intro or token like qualifying spot that they have to do. That's because that's what normally feels like on delay bays.
Mm. Wait, all right. It looks like we're starting, and it looks like it's a jam error. I hate everything.
It's all right. Sway versus Serpent. Okay. All right. So who hits far S better, right? Is that what it is?
Or 6AH or Puffball or EX Puffball.
There you go. There you go. All right. Good games.
All right.
Oh, no. All right. Oh, we're here.
So if this is a Serpent, I think it is. I believe he is from Seattle. So this is pretty much a coast-to-coast connection. And looks fine. There's no real problem.
Looks really good right now. Both went for a triple card as well. Which is good, by the way, because both of them are going to need their DPs in order to get out of each other's pressure.
Nah, they'll just do wake up for you.
Or you can just do this. Yeah, use it for combos. Gekirin, yep.
Alright, so Sui takes round one. Oh my! Okay, we're out here. I got here, Puffball. We got those? Yeah, we got those.
Pick it up.
Don't move. Just kidding, I'm gonna press 2D, I don't care. Alright, so Serpent's trying to mount offense, but Sway's like, nah, bro, I'm the better jam player. Oh god!
Wait.
Wait, you stunned? Oh,
This character hits you with a lot of H.
6H, 2H sometimes, jump H.
That's a lot of H.
Alright, so Sway takes game one, unless we missed game one ourselves already, and that was game two somehow.
Sway says it kicked him. I guess it kicked both players from the lobby.
Well,
but the lobby didn't die?
Yeah, that's weird.
Weird.
Shrug.
Yeah, sure. It's a beta.
You want to know what's not a beta, hopefully? Tekken 7 netcode right now?
Jesus. There's, I can't believe that fucking KOF is gonna get its rollback back, and we had this for like 3 weeks, and then we have Tekken 7 for season 4. I have fighting games to play. This is so weird. I started so many other video games that I was playing routinely, and now it's like last night I was like, man, I hadn't played Runeterra all day. And that's like so weird to me. Or like I hadn't played like Spelunky or like Call of Duty's coming out today. What am I doing? I want to play fighting games.
Yeah, because you got your rollback, bro.
Well, fighting games isn't where the money is.
I mean,
time to be I need to be a COD streamer, but I want to play Tekken.
Bro, you can do both.
Barely. It's hard, man. Tekken's hard. Yeah, you're right, actually.
Ooh, 6H. Damn, they hit from so far.
Yeah.
Alright, that's for 5K 6H. Sway's like, I'm trying to play the game. Nah. Oof, no conversion in the throat. Whew. He did Puffball, EX Puffball, like you're not moving.
Ever. Yep. I'm impressed that he didn't, I'll be honest with you.
Hey, go
bars. Hey, look at all those cards.
Just do EX card again. Just have like eight cards. To page.
Ooh,
almost. Right. So he's just trying to get a counter hit so he can get like maybe a Ryujin to knock Serpent back to the corner. Oh no!
Oh no! We got that, right?
Oh no! So close! Right. There you go. GX Puffball, carded Ryujin.
Yeah.
2D nice. Round start. That wasn't even the good DP. He just did wake up DP. Okay, Sway. Okay, Sway.
All right, we're going for cards.
Ooh, 2D server jump by accident. Hey, overhead, you gotta block high.
Almost.
Hey, 5D, you got this way? Yeah, he kinda does.
Wow, nice.
Yeah, he kinda does, okay.
Yeah, that's not easy to time.
Oh no!
No, and he got hit afterwards, that was a gold burst.
Alright, so he's just like, alright, I'm trying to close this out real quick. Trying to advance. Right. Trying to show people that I can play jam in multiple games. Oh, we got the dash for 2H?
Oh no!
Well, this is gonna hurt.
Cards.
5K looking, throw.
Yeah, looking for the overhead, I think.
Oh!
Ow!
Alright, knocked out. Yup. Oh my god, he's dizzy. He's dead. So what I saw there at that last exchange was it looked like Serpent wanted to do 2P, 2P, 2D, but he got Force Break cards, so that leads me to believe he was like buffering down too fast.
Oh, maybe. Yeah. That does happen a lot. At least like from the time I've spent playing Exert Jam, I felt like I got cards a lot on accident. You sort of have to be kind of deliberate with your cancels there.
This one of those things where people are just like, man, I wish old games weren't, you know, X, Y, and Z. And it's like, shut up. Shut up. Stop it.
I mean, I was surprised at coming back to this game, how it might have just been because it was the game I probably spent the most time of my life on.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I came back to this game and it didn't feel like that far off from Exert. In terms of like buffer and like stuff like that, like there was things that like there were some growing pains going back into it, but I don't think it was that bad.
No, because like the thing is, Exert and Plus R, they are different games in terms of like the mechanics for the most part.
Right.
But there's also like the whole speed thing. It's like I played a couple of games before I got here today, and like I could definitely feel myself playing at a much faster pace than. Exert sometimes, because sometimes in Exert you still have to like be able to keep up and make the quick decisions, but it feels like it does feel that Plus R is just smoother in terms of flow, batch flow.
Yeah, that's true. It's like stuff like there's situations like where Jam has the ability to just do like dash puffball and neutral like that from full screen because this game is just so much faster.
Because you get hit, you explode for real.
Yeah.
Because I know a lot of people say that about Exert. It's like, oh, if you get hit, you just die. And it's like, sometimes it feels like that, but usually it's like a clean hit doesn't lead to like 50% unless you have like, you know, resources. Where in this game, it's if you get like a certain hit with almost no resources, it feels like you just do Half-Life on most people.
It might be like you definitely can. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You definitely can.
Oh, there's so many people today. God,
I can't believe it. Actually, I thought it was gonna be. It might just be because it's like close to maybe the last tournament that we'll have before the beta. But I thought like going into the last week, people were gonna be like kind of tired out on it.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't seem like it's the case. People want to play Guilty Gear. That's just crazy.
Yeah, well, because I think it's like Friday and people are chilling, and then it's a Friday and most people are just like, oh, it's like 8 p.m. Cool, I can enter this tournament, no problem. And I think there's another Plus R tournament, Netplay tournament tomorrow, and then there's another one on Sunday.
That's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot. But it's good. People want to play video games right now.
I mean, hopefully people would want to play video games and not go outside.
Yeah, don't go outside.
Or if you're going to go outside, make sure you have a mask 6 feet away.
Lather yourself in
sanitizer.
In sanitizer, yeah, just every day.
Make sure you use the one that has the aloe.
Honestly, like, if you saw somebody who's just, like, butt naked and, like, just covered in sanitizer, you think you'd stay 6 feet away from them?
Definitely.
Absolutely. That's how you stay safe. None of you guys are committed.
Be as disgusting as possible.
Yeah, exactly.
Alright. Oh, green tea. Alright, so we have green tea versus Terragot. Terragort.
How does green tea have like 1600 matches?
They've probably been playing since before the rollback, I hope. Because it's been like 2 weeks, and to play like 1,000 games in 2 weeks is kind of nuts.
But is that necessarily better? That means he played on the old netcode.
So that's how he knows that this one's better, because he's had so many games on the old netcode. He comes to this one, he's just like, oh, rollback's amazing. I can do everything I normally want to do.
Yeah, but isn't that frightening that somebody would put themselves through that?
I don't know, because like a lot of people think Exert's netcode is not great. It's like serviceable, manageable. It's tough. Because there's a lot of people who can't, they don't have another outlet. It's just like, I want to play Exit, I'm just going to tough it out.
I mean, if you don't have anything else, I feel like it's fine, but like, people are also more lenient on netcode than I am. I play 1 to 3 frames, and if it jitters, like, I'm out. No, thank you. I think that's, like, the most beautiful thing about GGPO is that most of the jitters are gone. It makes it smoother, even if there's some rollbacks.
All right, so Faust versus Millie matchup. Green Tea already has Terragort in the corner. Reversal throw break. Wow.
Oh, get the combo? We have the big boy combos on Faust? I'm just going to go for knockdown.
Hey, force break this. Whoops.
Oh, he was trying to go in.
Oh, yeah, big body, close ass.
Yep. That's... I mean, Millia explodes in this game, so really, you get a few hits like this, Faust can come back.
Oh, no, meteors. Meteors, bro. Oh,
it's on the right side, though. He jumped into it to chicken guard.
Get the pin back. Oh, scalp
pull. Down.
Bomb. Ooh,
we have 2 air dashes. That's not a problem.
All right, knockdown. Force break this. Time to guess. Ah, you guessed wrong, buddy. Oh, damn, we're still going in.
Keep it up.
Don't want to let Faust get started throwing out items because that control. Oh, no, it's happening. But yeah, Millia Silent Force in this game. It happens so quickly. Lumans.
Hey,
he should be dead. Yep.
This is the game where she had 2 versions of Silent Force, right? She has the one where she hops slightly before she does it.
Yes, I think that one's the Force Break. She has Force Break Silent Force, right?
I don't think so. I think she just has H Silent Force. Oh, she has 3 versions.
Is it HS?
She has 3. What's the 3rd one?
I don't remember.
She has K-Pin? What does that even do?
She's more plus.
I'd be so pissed. Oh my god, they're right.
She has 3 pins.
Oh, S is tiny hop, H is big hop. Alright, got it. Thank you.
As we just saw, we saw big hop. Jump D hits the wrong way too. Alright, Green Tea doesn't have pin. It's right there, but it's on Faust to make sure she can't get there safely. Oh, reversal, wake up throw, guilty new classic.
Yeah, probably got a little bit greedy on like 2 Kaoki.
Hey. And that's what you can do versus Millie.
Oh, no! Anything but that!
I can't believe my items have been used against me. Oh. Reversal throw, meteors, wow. Versus everything in the item toss.
Yeah, everything to protect him from getting comboed further, which is nice. Throw comboed, yep.
Let's break this, Loki. Yep, time to guess. GG. Damn, imagine Millia having a disc that hits 3 times, giving her 2 additional mix-ups. Isn't that wild? Should get the knockdown here. Yep, time to guess again. Hey, hair car. Oh.
Oh no. This is where you can get started.
Ooh, all right, okay.
Yeah, that was a good read on that.
Burst himself, but the meteors are coming. Alright, so you can see Green Tea's just trying to get the hole. Damn, the anti-air on the disc set.
Yeah.
Ooh, 6p. Ooh,
yeah, that was really nice.
I think he thought he had a burst, that's why he jump canceled.
Winger!
I've never seen that happen. I've never seen that trade like that. That was weird.
Oh, man.
Wait, she has Air Winger in this game?
Yes, she has Air Winger in this game.
What the hell? Bro, I forgot she had that.
Yeah, she has Air Winger.
Oh. Yo, what's wrong with this game?
I mean, I guess it's a trade for having a Winger lose invincibility like as soon as she gets out of off the air.
That's true, like, but it's just a better combo filler.
Hold on. Yeah, it loses invincibility like 1 frame after startup.
Hmm.
So it's like, I guess it's fine. Air Winger looks sick too.
She just goes down.
Yeah, that looks cool. It's like they gave her direct hit dandy.
I don't need Milia doing direct hit Danny off of full screen corner carry into like 60% because she got two hit. I don't need that.
I mean, whatever. It makes the round go quicker.
That's true. A lot of your games go fast.
Right. Looks like we've got another match. It's going to be A3 Religion versus Roldy.
That name sounds really familiar. Roldy. Somebody help! Ooh, we have a bracket. Elden Shadow is first seed since he won last week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's so many people in this bracket. I saw Pachpi. Mahoka's, of course, in here. I didn't know Drew Chuck plays.
Huh. Oh my god.
Wait, I have my own bracket.
Challenge, just let me scroll down past Group A. Please.
Never.
Oh my god. Okay.
Jesus.
Where is this in the bracket? This humongous bracket.
You think this bracket's big? Check out Sunday's bracket. That's like 400 people, right?
It'll give me nightmares. I don't want to.
Yeah, I actually don't want to think about that either.
Do a 400-man bracket, all in the same bracket. They're not broken up into groups or anything.
I would.
They get printed out on one paper that gets posted onto the wall.
You need a ladder to like check off the names.
Okay, you know what? That would be mad sick though.
Actually, yeah. We'd have to do it at like a major.
Yeah. But it would be like one huge bracket, and like it's just like plastered on the back wall.
Go up to the paper to see your name.
And then we need somebody's like short to do it, because it'd be funnier.
Nah, because it would be tight. I'd be tight, bro. Get out of here.
What do you mean? We give him a ladder. Everybody would need a ladder at that point.
That's true. But why
would
it
be funnier?
I'm blind.
At their expense? That's wrong.
But they get no, we'll pay them. It'll be fine.
Are we paying them to be a spectacle?
Yeah. But like also like you're getting paid to like for like on brackets? You're doing the bracket.
Okay. That's better. If you had said they're getting paid to run the bracket,
No. Like they're also like constantly updating the bracket. And then like you can have a camera on the back wall. Like to show, like to constantly go back to.
Okay.
I think that would be cool. It'd be like all the Japanese tournaments, instead of like having an entire paper for like four fucking people.
Oof.
Like you'd have it for like you'd have one big paper for the like everybody.
Right.
Oh, okay, I see. This is a winner's round 3 match, and the winner's round 2 matches just haven't, recorded scores haven't shown up in Chalon. I think that's
what's going on here. You gotta wait, right?
Maybe, I don't know. What I do know is that I'm going to ping A3 Religion.
He's still not here?
That is correct.
Ahmad, where the hell are you, bro?
Come on, man.
You have a family.
They need food.
I mean, that would be a reason to not be here on time.
No, you need to feed your kid.
Oh, yeah, you gotta hustle in the dough.
Yep, any way you can. So how's everybody doing tonight? My work day was relatively not too stressful, which is really good.
It was just like condensed today.
Yeah.
It was just a lot of work really fast.
How long was your access stream yesterday?
It's a normal 2 hours like that they do in online. But
I saw like a half hour and I was like, oh, this is pretty good. It's like
just me losing in a platformer.
It happens, bro.
God. I considered like watching a lot of like other VTubers and stuff like that play Mario 64 or other Mario games, because that's just a guilty pleasure of mine.
Mm-hmm.
I really wanted to go back to one of them, like Sunshine or something, or like I haven't played Galaxy in forever. I've replayed 64 and Sunshine since, but I haven't replayed Galaxy. But I don't know how to emulate that. Like, I don't know how that would work onto a. I have never done Wii emulation, so I don't know how that would work on like on a computer, or if that is even a thing.
Wii emulation works very well. Just Dolphin. Because remember the Wii is just like three GameCubes stuck together.
I need that image now.
Like in terms of architecture, it's like very similar. So Dolphin works.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, which is why the Wii can just play GameCube games easily.
That's so sick. I thought that was so cool.
Yeah, backwards compatibility is great.
Remember when backwards compatibility wasn't a thing you had to worry about?
Yeah.
You just got to the next console and you're like, hey, you can play games back again.
Cool.
Evan, that's almost 1,000 games, damn.
What?
Yeah, he's probably played like he's obviously played before the beta, but I don't know how much of this is before the beta, honestly.
Mainstream Sato.
Why is his name so long? I hate you, Ahmad. Wait, that's not Ahmad.
It might be Mainstream Sato.
Why is he playing Zappa?
Why is he playing Zappa?
We're about to find out.
All right. Well, for your viewing pleasure, at least, here's a match.
All right. So, Aether Religion playing Zappa. And then we have Roldy. I remembered he's from Canada now. Okay. I miss the Canadians so much. I want to go back to Canada for UMAD.
Yeah, right. UMAD's always been like a fun time.
Bro, y'all need to just show up on me. It's great.
I will. As soon as hell is done freezing over. Oof. Anyway, you can't put Sato in your name and not play Johnny. What is this shit?
Alright. I mean, it's a Steam name. It's the longest Steam name known to man. I hate it.
Second generation mainstream Sato is so sick, though.
He's had ghosts this whole time.
Yeah, and it's kind of perfect for playing against Venom. Venom hasn't been able to set a ball this entire time.
He got Ghost again.
Yep.
What's with Zappa players and getting like the same summon throughout the whole match?
I have no clue, honestly.
Like, I thought that was RNG. Well, not RNG, but you can kind of time it. It's weird. Ooh, jumpy. Yeah, he's just trying to like create space to throw out Ghost the whole time.
Yeah, but he's close to negative penalty. It might be worth it at this point. He doesn't have any meter to give up.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. He still maintains his ghost. Well, alright. Alright, Ghost FRC. Look at this cool guy. Yeah, he's always running back to the other side of the screen to make sure that Venom can't actually just, like, tag him, get a knockdown, and start setting up. But he's getting hit. He might. Yeah, there's a ghost.
Alright. So he's one orb away? So he just doesn't. Like, as long as you don't get hit by a ghost, you're good.
But the time's up.
Oh my god. I just didn't realize that was a time up in a plus R match. Oh my god.
Yeah, you could do those.
I mean, barely. That's so weird, man. I have not had that happen to me or seen it once in a tournament yet. Since GGPO has started.
Mm-hmm. Ghost FRC again. And once again, you can see Aether Religion just making sure that Roldy can't really like get a clean knockdown, but he's able to set up some cue balls. Alright. Got him blocking. Oh no. Uh-huh. Oh, get stripped up again.
Lucky, yeah.
He is taking that much damage, but it's adding up.
It's being annoying. The ghost curse is just constantly keeping him from like fully realizing his pressure.
Hey.
Oh yeah, I forgot jump D wall bounce.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if it does an exit.
No, he has the flip up in exit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, Stinger. Ooh.
Nice.
Singer FRC 2G.
Yeah.
Alright, so Roldy's on the board. DP doesn't get the summon because he got hit with the ball right after.
Oh no, he got bursted into the corner too.
But then he did DP and he got swords on help! Swords on the screen, help! Hey, jump K, it's really high up. Cross up, yep.
It's a dark angle.
Hold all that damage.
That was sick.
You stay over there. Alright, well, it seems I have a decent control of this match right now. Dog. Oh, dog's off.
I love shmup venom. It's so sick.
It also tests your knowledge of how you're able to like use the system mechanics to get to the other side of the screen.
Yeah.
And avoid chip.
This was the thing I always thought, like, Black Snake was the best in the world at. Like, when he started playing shmup venom, like, I felt like the second you felt like you had the way to get in, you just got 6-speed.
I remember, Vanilla Accent Core Venom 6-speed?
Oh my god.
There's a lot of Japanese players who are playing Vanilla Accent Core exclusively on NetPlay, and it's like, huh. Wouldn't you guys want to play Plus R? And they're like, no, we want to play this, because most of the Japanese players they played Accent Core for the longest time. Plus R came out, and I think they had stopped playing Guilty Gear when Plus R came out.
Their gap between Exerd and AC, their gap between Plus R and Exerd was way smaller than ours, because they had it in February in the on the arcade release. We had to wait way longer for Exerd, so we had Plus R in the meantime.
Right.
So I can understand why they feel like that they don't have like any real attachment to Plus R. But also it feels like a lot of those guys are playing AC are just playing it as like nostalgia and just having fun with it, which is, you know, fine on its own. Just AC is a mega busted game. Not like this one isn't, but there's busted things I don't want to come back to, I'll be honest.
Yeah. Like, I know a lot of people are like, oh, Eddie LOL, and it's like, fam.
No! Does nobody remember? Eddie LOL.
It's like, skills, haha. Look at 2-2 D4 spray. Check it out, guys.
Hey, guess what? I got a fucking hit with Eddie, and now here's 80% of your health because I reset you in an unblockable.
And then you die.
And then you're dead. And then you're on the other side of the screen, and you have to deal with neutral again. Sick.
Oh, you got counter hit by Shark? Goodbye.
Now you're dead.
Interesting.
Wait, what happened?
What the hell? Yeah, I think there might have been a desync.
Yeah, because I saw that what's it called? This menu took forever to load up.
Yeah, it was. But then also, like, look at the if you see the screenshot that A3 Religion posted. There's like, he's got Rao.
Hmm?
Which is not what we saw, right?
Yeah, we
oh.
We didn't see Rao.
No, we did not see Rao. what a funny way to desync.
It's like, bro, I got Rao. What's going on here?
You guys are losing to like just a Phantom Rao or something.
It's like, bro, I got Rao here. Roll that back.
I want a Zapper player to lose because they get Sword and it rolls back to Ghost or some shit.
That'd be hilarious. It's like, cool, I got Sword, time to go in, and it's Ghost, and you do the wrong move, and you're like, oh, I died. Alright, let's try this again. It seems like that is A3 Religion playing Zapper.
Okay.
Probably trying something new. He was just like, oh, I've always wanted to play this character.
I always wanted to cause desyncs with RNG.
Yeah.
I mean, also, have you seen his name? I think if you have too many characters in your Steam name, it also causes issues.
What? Really?
I think so. I have to double check that.
I hate computers.
I mean, that's why we're always fixing them, right? That's why people are needed. Whew. All right. So you can see already that A3 Religion has quite a life lead, mostly because he got ghosts. I don't know how he's manipulating RNG. I mean, there is actually a way to know like which summon you will get based off of the timer, position of the timer. Oh god. It's like he got dog right there, and I think it was because he got 5 or 4 on the timer. I have to double check.
Oh. I did not know that you can sort of figure out when you get certain ones.
That's what I heard, but then there's also times where I've seen matches where they just get the same summon repeatedly.
Yeah. Timer. Yeah.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, God!
Oi!
Yeah, almost combo. Just run up DP, run up DP.
I'm so surprised. Oh my God, he can't be on the ground, he needs to get on the ground!
Bro, all he had to do is just run up DP and he probably would have died due to chip.
Yeah.
Alright, Stinger. Ooh, that's a DP. Run under. I'm out. Ooh, alright, teleport up the corner. You see A3 just trying to make sure he can get like a safe summon somehow. Or just get a clean hit like that. Oh no. But this wasn't the greatest throw. Alright, now Roldy has a ghost on him. Dead angle. Not anymore. Ooh, footsies.
ghost headbutts, yeah. Alright. You can see how the match changes when he has ghosts.
I mean, he's going in.
Nice blocks, though.
All right, we'll get some space. Doesn't get a clean hit. Oh, there we go. Ghost gone. Or now you have to deal with sword. Good luck. Both players being careful. They don't want to get knocked down. Well, he still keeps his turn, but he has quite a life lead. He has to swing out. Ooh.
Oh no. This is good. This is good. Block on the mat, struggle.
Oi.
Yeah, DP.
Oh, dog.
Oh, no, dog sandwich.
10 seconds left. I don't think he has enough time, because he doesn't have meter either.
Yeah, not unless he gets like a huge hit of some sort. Yeah, not no way right now.
Yeah, you just give this round up. Okay.
It's so weird we're getting timeouts.
Alright. What do you mean that's weird? I try not to interact with Venom, bro.
Like regular weird, or maybe reducing weird?
No. Regular weird. Like, it's just, it's so cool that, like, both these guys are just more focusing on being on opposite sides of the screen and looking for, like, a good hit, rather than just, like, trying to force neutral in some way. Like, both Roldy and A3 are, like, basically trying to approach it in the same way, where they go for a knockdown first before they even approach.
Hey, Arthur, let's go. To be knocked down burst, get off me. Gets ghost again. I have to keep getting ghosts. Oh. DM, get that thing.
All right, dubious curve.
Yeah, that was a thing.
That was a thing.
Oh no, dead angle, dog. Get him, boy.
Oh no, no, no. Yeah, this is not where we want to be. Oh, he doesn't have any meter to FD either.
Ooh. All
right. Summon. Oh boy.
I think that overhead's like plus as well, right?
Yep. If I recall correctly, that is the case. Unsummon is +3.
And I think you can OTG after with summon again. So you just do like unsummon whatever orbs you have. If you have Rao, you just dash up summon. You have Rao now.
Yep.
For the low cost of 25 meter.
For the low cost of 25 meter, you two can get another overhead for whatever reason. Does he have like 4 overheads?
Doesn't he only have 2 in non-summon mode?
I think he actually only has 3 between 5H, 5D, and unsummon. Oh no, and 6H. 6H is also an overhead.
Oh, right.
Oh, so yes, he does have 4.
That's a lot of overheads. Bonk, bonk. Oh, Stinger gets rid of the ghost. A3's trying to figure out if he... Oh! Doesn't block the high. Cross on it. Damn. Ooh, Lantern.
Plus frames. Wow, just DP's out.
Ooh! Oh, we almost had all the queen blocks. So, swinging. Dead angle? Yeah, there it is.
Yep.
Stingwire C2D knockdown.
Combo off Mad Struggle too. We got the Dubious Curve, so Electric Ball. Yes! Yes! That's why Dubious Curve is so sick.
Yeah, I wish you still had that. I'm not gonna lie to you.
I like it way more than QB.
QB, yeah. But I understand that there's different utilizations for these moves.
Right. QB is, I think, also technically easier to use than Dubious Curve, but...
Boxing Red?
Oh, no.
Hey!
The three summon?
Yep.
Oh, no knockdown. But he doesn't have to deal with any summons. 6P.
Nice. He hit that 6P on the floor, too, so he got close S to combo. That was sick.
Oh god, Goldburst. Time to party. Dog. Hey, jump H.
Yeah, Roldy has meter, though, this time, so he can faultless out of there, which is really nice.
Alright, so it looks like he's just holding his ground, making sure that he doesn't eat any random ghost hit. But at the same time, making sure he doesn't have to, like, backdash too far into the corner. Oh, not him.
Dark Angel?
Ooh.
Oh, that took all of his meter, too.
Ooh! I'm trying to switch some...
Combo? Yeah!
Alright, Roldy takes it 2-1 over
Ethereum.
Wait, no, that's 1-1.
No, isn't that 2-1?
There's a desync in the first match, right?
Oh, right!
Oh, okay.
Oh, that was, oh.
Good, one more.
We get more, yay!
Yeah, we get more! I'm happy.
I'm happy, but at the same time, I hope that doesn't happen too much.
Yeah, same. Godpress. Godpress said if it's 2, it's ghost. If it's 1, it's dog. If it's 0, it's sword. What does that mean? 2 is the ending number or like what it's divisible by?
The last number. So when it goes 99, 98, on 8, it'll give you the summon.
Oh, okay. That's weird.
Ooh, air throw. Let's go. Yep, he knows not to burst there. Stingy. Alright, we have sword. Overhead. Rip. Alright, Rold is making sure he doesn't have to get hit by sword. Hey, clean jumping. Burst by A3. Knockdown. Hey, TK struggle.
Uh-huh.
Empty low.
Yes! Why is Dubious Curve so sick?
Bro, Venom sequences are the coolest thing.
Oh, this character is so awesome.
And he's brown.
God, when Venom gets to go off, there it's just mwah. It's beautiful.
Queen. Ooh, jump S, knockdown. Time to guess. Ooh. All right, A3 block. Forehead burst.
Yeah, he had to burst. He was already sandwiched and near the corner.
Hey, wait, dead angle, sword. Ooh. Right, back to full screen. No, just kidding.
Mm-hmm.
That's something.
Alright, got the burst as well. Rolly's in a really, really good position as long as he doesn't get knocked down.
Oh god.
Oh no. Sandwich, he doesn't have meter for dead angles either. Centipede.
All right, back to sword. Yeah, he can just walk on your stinger aim.
Yeah.
Boom, boom, boom. Will he spin meter?
He's gonna kill with red hail?
Nope, because that doesn't kill anybody ever.
Sucks. If he did, he would be the best Venom player in the world.
Hey, full screen stinger.
That's how it works.
Bro, that super is so bad.
That is maybe the worst super. Routinely in Guilty Gear, but if you win with that, then you're the best. You're the best Venom player. That's how it works. Nobody wins with that super.
All right, so barring the first game that we saw,
yeah,
that was due to desyncs. It is 2-1 and Roldy sweep.
Roldy ended up taking it, but man, that. Good Venom is so sick.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I'm looking through the groups that we have. So, the group that we have is C&D.
Yes, I believe so.
Yes, we do. Okay, cool. Cool.
Oh, man. There's some good matches coming up.
I see Prusa. I see Nova. KB Nova.
Kenji the God?
Yep.
I wonder who Kenji's playing. I haven't seen him play yet.
Oh, I just saw that result. Damn. Ooh, let's go, Crocs. Spoilers, Crocs beat Sway.
Oh, no.
Let's go, Crocs.
Oh, no. Crocs versus Krakatoa. That'll be fun. That'll be a fun match.
There's a hilarious tweet involving Crocs that I... I need to find. I need to find that tweet.
Holy what a monster.
God. Uh-oh. Fiestament's here.
Woo! Yep. Yeah, I know, right? Oh, big homie Fiestament's in the building. There you go. Oh, there it is. I was looking for Black Snake.
Alright, so we have Fiestament versus Isaac Gay.
What are these people with, like, 1,800 matches? What?
Yeah, I don't...
What?
The net played...
You net played ago. The previous version of this net code? You monsters?
Bro, they didn't know what they had that could have been good. They were just like, oh, we can net play. Let's go.
Bro, fun. If there's lag in my card game, I'm turning it off. All right? Like, I can't handle this.
If I don't know how... 90 MS, I can't play.
If that shit goes above 80, I am out.
All right,
no,
so
thank you.
Bridget versus Testament. I would think that Testament has an okay time fighting Bridget, mostly because he has the ability to place nets, skull, the trees, and just Barneys in general.
Yeah, even his Oki is sort of like not that attached to like a specific timing, right? He can he can let go of Barneys whenever he wants, as long as it's not immediate, right? And nets and trees pop up not when. You know, you're knocked down on not a set timer, but rather when you walk over them. It's like Oki's really, really nice for Testament versus Bridget.
And then he's got like huge buttons that stops Bridget just from trying to fly in the air like he wants to and just disrupt all the space.
Right. Like, oh wow, big counter hit though.
Get him, Roger! Robley, Roger! Hey, wake up throw. Classic. Oh wow, you got that on Bridget? Damn.
Yeah, that's crazy. And you wanted to keep the corner, so that's why you didn't use Badlands.
Alright, Roger Oki blocks the cross up. Oh no! Oof. Yeah, delay wake up. Bridget has yo-yo out, he gets a delay wake up. Oof, lucky. Tree, yeah! Oh, trying to get the meter with the gold burst.
Almost. Kind of awkwardly high for Testament in that situation. That situation, though. I mean, Bridget's got a lot of meter. Oh, maybe could have used it there. We're just going to use it for me and my killing machine.
Oh, RC, yep.
Oh, oi.
Testament not pressing buttons.
Wait.
Good block. Can't really punish from that far. Wasn't going to full hit. Tree, yeah, good block.
That was a really, really good ball. Yo!
Get him, Roger! Get him!
Roger from the top rope.
Ooh. You gotta remember, Roger does hit low when he like slides on the floor like that, so you have to block low. Alright, there's the burst. Fiestament's like, I'm trying to play the game here, get off me.
Ooh, let's go! What? What? Fiestament, what was that?
Alright, Peg gets a hit overhead. Oh, that hit's high. You gotta be careful. Jump S. Oh no, that burst is terrible! No. But it was a panic burst. It was one of those, oh no, I got hit with 2% HP time the burst, and I lose anyway. It's one of those.
This is one of those situations where, like, if you were to talk to me at any moment that wasn't right now, I would be super mad that they gave Testament a regular teleport. But at that moment, that was so cool.
Yeah, that was sick. Because I thought he dropped this combo, but then it was like, wait, Bridget fell into the tree. He teleported to the tree and got a conversion.
Oh, that was so sick. That was incredible. I have not seen anything like that. Not at that range.
Testament combos are cool sometimes.
They're cool sometimes, which is unfortunate. Because this character's evil.
Terrorist. But if you want power, you play this character.
That's true.
Alright. So if you have to be setting up some trees, Jesus, that Barney from Deep.
Down.
Oh, the trade. Testament got up first, though, so he was able to 2P meaty.
Force Break Skull is just chilling. Oh, no.
Just take it. Yeah, it's better for this character to actually move.
All right, that's it up. Peace me out. Thanks, Roger. Hey, he was still on the floor. RC. Oh, my God. Roger took the hit for the team. Uh-oh. Testament Oki. Probably tried to jump out. Got tagged.
Yeah, probably. I mean, that happens a lot, especially with that normal. Like, 2H specifically is just so good since it moves forward.
Has upper body in the roll for some reason.
Yeah.
Oh god, we're all bad land. Oh no, didn't block the overhead. Alright. Barney's on there, pet attachment. Peace be out. Except not really. Are you back in the corner?
Look at all the damage from the poison too. He just happened to trade.
Hey, Hitomi.
It'd be like that.
Yep. You know what's crazy impressive about Fiestament is that like pretty much anybody who's learned to play plus R and in or plus R Testament sort of really focuses on like the Mega Oki aspect of that character now. He's like still super good at like neutral. And like there was like we saw him really put him in the blender like once, maybe twice. Most of that was just him doing, just having fantastic neutral.
Which a lot of people do, it seem to ignore when people are playing Testament, because it's not easy to just put up nets and webs and trees, because like, if done improperly, people just get free punishes free on you.
Yeah, not only free punishes, but they're also like easy to remove. So it's like you basically wasted your time doing nothing.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. I see my boy Croxislox there.
Oh, this one's going to be so good. I think this is going to be a dope match.
Yeah, up against Krakatoa, who played last week. They got top 8. Strong Faust player.
Yeah, definitely. He's definitely been the one I've been doing a lot of watching, because I've been playing a lot of plus R Faust, and he seems to be like one of the guys that has really proven himself to be like a top Faust player in plus R. Obviously along with Elvin, but we've known that for decades.
Mm-hmm.
At this point,
people are just like, oh, of course Elvin Shadow's good at his character. He's been playing for like 10 plus years.
Yeah, I know. I'm pretty sure he invented the code that is the RNG for this character.
He breaks the RNG. Have you seen some of the items he gets?
Exactly.
Alright. So, Slayer versus Faust. It's not a good time for Slayer. Except when he gets to like, around the 5k range is when Slayer starts to like, make things get messy. But here, it's suffering.
Oh, nice counter. Almost got the full combo. Knocked down.
Not blocking jump 2K. Oh no, it's got pull. Chop.
Yeah, decides not to burst there, because it would have basically just blown him to the other side of the screen.
Croc's not able to get anything started. Door. Oh no, door wrong way.
Plus frames. Immediately bumps out of there.
Uh-oh. Reversal throw? Oh no. Oh my god, Goldburst, trying to play the game.
Yeah, yep, yep.
That was the Goldburst of, please Slayer, you can never play the game, I will die. I will cry.
Yeah. Alright. Immediately jumps out of there. That's been like, really the biggest part, is that the couple times where Crox has gotten a knockdown, he hasn't been able to get Oki. Or any good Oki.
Ooh,
there
six,
we go.
6 AFB dandy.
Oh, just let's knock down. Oh no!
Hold this wake up throw. Oh no, he got hit by hammer. Oh.
Toss.
Boom! Boom! Oh no, he got hit! Alright, tries the fuzzy jump out. Little man's.
Oh, it's too early.
doesn't try to sideswap, gets thrown.
That is such a ballsy throw.
Especially because...
From downtown!
Imagine trying to do anything versus Slayer when he has 50 meter.
Oh man, super so sick. Alright, already got the burst out of Krakatoa. That's a huge win for Slayer.
Oh, reversal throw meteors and little man's! He got the insurance plan. He got the fire and the flood prevention. Wait.
Oh no.
I thought that 5D was gonna autocorrect.
Yeah. This combo's so rude.
Meteors.
Oh no!
Oh! Oh no.
We got those.
Yeah, Faust doesn't have guts, guys. This is gonna suck.
Just kidding. Little Mans!
Little Mans with the assist.
Yeah, Cross was doing... He had a better foothold of what was going on, but that last sequence of meteors coming down and messing him up was the turning point, because he didn't think he had a better chance to burst, so it looked like he wanted to hold on to it.
Yeah. I mean, I felt like most of that was that Krokensox wasn't able to get the most out of his knockdowns for the most part. Oh no, the dark side! Krox, I was a fan! How could you? How could you do this to me?
He wants power. He's like, he sees power, he's like, ah yes, I'm not like these other people who hate the thing that makes you strong. I will just become strong and kill the people who try to hate me. Ah yes,
at least he picked the Eva color. Alright.
Alright. Let's see if he actually knows how to play this character though, because Justice doesn't have a proper run. She kinda just like glides. Really
as
slow.
Much as I hate this character, she's not easy to play.
Right. Going my way. And Krakatoa's just like, let's see how well you can do while I'm rushing you down.
That was weird. I have to always remind myself which one's Michael Blade and which one's Michael Sword.
Yeah, I don't remember either.
I'm gonna guess Michael Blade is the special move.
If you're Justice expert,
wrong.
Please tell us.
I'm wrong. Michael Blade's the super. Michael Sword's the special. Yeah. I will always forget that.
Ooh, all right, anti-air. Stop trying to jump on Faust. He has 2K. He has a million anti-airs. He got obliterated!
He got hit by every meteor!
Oh,
I don't think I've ever seen that before!
Bro, Justice is just fat. That's all it is.
This is a big character, I know.
Oh, you could have gobbled off that. That would have been sick.
He has so much meter. Counter. Okay. Be careful with your burst. Okay, there you go. Oh,
scary.
Meteors again. Oh god.
Of course, it's a Faust player.
Hello. Crocs, no.
GG's.
He saw his chance. He was like, "Yes, I must do it."
You know what's the real mix-up? The real mix-up is actually just doing front door.
Yeah, a lot of people don't expect front door. When they're just like, oh, he's going to do door, it's like front door really mess you up.
That's always, because every time you use door, the only time people use door is when they want to do force break door. But then you do front door. Haha. That's a secret. That's a secret. You have to suck, so then you have to use different things. Use good players' tendencies to fuel your bad ones.
True.
That's how you play fighting games.
Is it my birthday? Hey, it's a black snake though.
It's my birthday. Let's go. I'm so happy.
Oh. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that, I guess.
It's gonna be like that.
Alright. So in case y'all don't know, Black Snake, originally he started playing in Sharp Reload? Someone help? I'm gonna guess Sharp Reload because he's an old man. And Jace, also one of the older Guilty Gear players from way back in the day. I don't think he plays Exert, I'm pretty sure he only plays like Plus R.
Mm-hmm.
But this should be Venom versus Bridget, if I'm correct.
Unless things have changed.
Well, I saw Black Snake play like an hour ago, so he was definitely playing Venom.
Okay, good. Oh man, I am super mega ultra pumped to watch Black Snake. This guy is a huge reason why I love Venom as a character. Because I watched Black Snake play. It's like Black Snake and Enno. I watched them play Venom and I was like, this character can do anything. that's how I really felt. I felt like that character was just like a mashable, like whatever you can think up of, you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
And like the way, yeah, it's, I'll let us play speak for itself. But yeah, Black Snake and Enno were like, for me, they've always just been like the pinnacle of Venom.
I miss Enno.
I do miss Enno.
But that's a different time, though. It's a different time. No more.
We're like 13 years removed from that at this point. Because even in BlazBlue, Enno was a god.
All right. Oh, they picked this song, Jesus. I mean, this song's not that bad.
It's fine.
Alright, let's see how Black Snake's gonna catch Jace, because Bridge is one of those characters that just flies everywhere, honestly.
Yeah, you also have to commit to stuff like that as Venom, because you don't really have defensive options without Meter.
Alright, you can see Black Snake, he's keeping up a good pace. He's making sure any of the balls that are hit into the air at least approach Bridget in some weird fashion, so that way he can get a hit.
Ooh! Oh! Force Red Hat struggle?
Oh, clean hit, let's go. Knockdown? Oh, TG though.
Yeah, I don't know if he wanted that, but it's not the worst thing to send her on the other side of the screen.
Hey, there's the burst to get off me. Blocks the FB Roger.
Yeah, Force Break Stinger!
Force Break Stinger is definitely one of those tools that you think, like, why did this character get this? And then you're like, ah, yes, because all the characters in the game exist that rush you down.
Yep. It's such a sick move. Oh, wow.
That barely
doublehead hit from downtown.
Ooh. OD.
Ah.
Dead angle, not punished, but Jay still gets in.
Over. Yo, do you see this defense, though?
Yeah, he's trying not to get knocked out.
Ooh, wow, I can't believe he blocked that.
He felt it in his bones. He's like, he's gonna burst.
Yeah, he really did. Look how much damage Venom took.
Uh-oh. Double jump, ball set.
Paper mache character.
Whew. Wait, where's Roger? Oh! Like, there needs to be a Roger indicator.
Nah, the fact that we even have, like, indicators for, like, Dizzy Fish and, like... Oh, wow!
He tried to do wake-up throw.
Yeah, he did wake-up throw of us.
It's like, hey, hold this close ass that hits three times that I can have years to confirm. Cool. But I don't think Bridget has a real way to punish close S. If done on wake up like that.
Wake up 6, or Oki 6K.
But 6K doesn't hit on like until like really late, right?
Yeah, I get. I guess you might actually still get blown up for doing. Well, you just have to time it to beat the OS timing or the like wake up button timing and the throw. So it'll be tight. It'll be like 5 frames or so, but. You can still do it.
Alright. Jace just trying to get in. But Proof is just like, ha, I've been playing this game longer than you, I think. Oof. Back to mid-screen. Proof is trying to figure out how he, like, is able to get any stingers, get any sets. Oh my god!
And he bubbled off it! Dark Angel?
Hold his corner. Wait, he didn't empty any of that. He just ate the chip.
Nah, it's fine.
It's not!
No, it's not.
Oh! That's hard to air dash over, especially in the corner.
Yeah.
Ooh, let's go! Ridge of Pressure, time to guess.
Me and my killing machine. No. Don't burst that, please.
Yeah, it's... It doesn't go away if he gets hit.
No.
Ooh. Knocked out for the match real quick. Ooh, cross up.
And the combo. Woo! That was sick. Roger gets the other way.
From the top of the screen. Ding, ding, ding.
Ooh.
Nice. That got some much needed room. He could have comboed.
Stinger. So Jace is going in like, screw it. I can be full screen, but I don't want this guy just throwing stuff at me. Ooh, Stinger FRC to Chase.
Hey! Oof.
Double overhead! Oh my god. Oh my god!
Hey. Oh, counter hit! Oh no!
Loops!
Wait,
Loops!
He's dead!
Did you see that risk?
It was flashing, so yeah, I had to see it. Uh-oh. Alright, Jason's about to get his burst back. He might burst here. Oh, he was feeling it!
Oh, yo, H?
Yeah, you gotta FD that or else he becomes air unblockable. Yeah, pretty sure.
H mad struggle.
Oh, no, Roger, okay.
Hey!
Do it again. Yes!
Loops! Hit him with the loops!
Alright, shoot. Double head Morbid. He has no meter to cancel. It's okay. Alright, Jay's trying to get back in there somehow. Oh, air throw.
Ooh, that dash. Oh, my God.
Tries up Stinger. Wait, what's happening? What's going on?
Is he doing this on purpose?
He is.
Oh my god, he was bouncing the Force Break Carcass Raid between the two other balls.
So if...
What?
If anybody knows Prusha, right then, he probably took a big pull of his vape and just like sprayed smoke everywhere. It's like, that was good.
That was nice.
Because when he feels himself or when he does something cool, he just takes a long drag and he just smoke everywhere.
Yep. That was so crazy. I didn't even think he meant it. That's how crazy it was.
Yeah, no, but like he played this game like so much. It's just one of those things where you understand if I do this, I could probably just like make this work. This will probably work. Whatever. Screw it. And a lot of people don't have that forethought in this game because Guilty Gear is very disjointed in a lot of situations, because if something hits in a weird way, there's no immediate do this. It's like, here's five other things you could probably do and they might work.
Yeah, I mean, for the most part, when like things go awry in gear, usually like just try to plug it up as best as you can, like just go for a quick knockdown or set up or something like that. But woof. This is, like, I don't know how to explain this to people who hadn't seen Prusha before, like, before Exert. But, like, this is why I liked watching this. This is why I thought Venom was so sick as a kid. Because I watched this guy play. And he was crazy.
He was definitely one of the reasons why a lot of people were just like, damn, this character looks mad complicated. And he's like, no, you just kind of just do stuff and it works. Because I think he said something like that like years ago when people were talking to him and I was around. But he's definitely one of the more creative players when it comes to his character. When you hear Black Snake, you're like, oh, it's that Venom player. Like instantly, you know, he's that Venom player.
What really strikes me from Black Snake is the undeniable fact that he has so many games under his belt that he can think of anything and make it happen, right? Like it's not that he hasn't been in a training mode, is that he's been in so many different situations with that character that he understands what to do at any given time. And it's just about executing it or reacting to it properly.
All right, up next looks like we have Kugi back once again for this week's match, and he's playing against Wukash.
Ooh,
okay.
Ooh, this should be a good one.
So Wukash played Anji and Baikin in this version of this game, but he played Baikin in Exert because there's no Anji.
Right.
So I don't know who either of them are gonna play because Kuyi does play a bunch of characters, and I think Rukash plays a few more characters outside of Anji and Lycan.
I imagine. I think every time I've seen Rukash play so far, I've seen him play Anji. For the most part, I mean. Which I'd also want him to see, because he's a super cool Anji to watch.
Alright, it's Anji versus Slayer. So, this version of Anji has a ton of auto guard.
And it's sideways DPs.
Yeah, think of a DP that goes sideways. Think of Ryu sliding with his DP. That's what Fusion is like.
You know, that's what Ryu needs in Street Fighter 6. He just needs Tatsu to just have...
have invul frames?
Yeah, just have invul frames and guard point.
This sounds terrifying.
Yeah, force breaker in.
Yeah, talking about auto guard, that burst was almost really bad. Because if Kuyi was a little bit higher, Wukash would have been able to like duck it and then get a proper punish.
But...
Jump K. Oh my god.
Wukash, are you from Cali? I didn't know.
It's a bad tendency. It's like, I can run this back. Watch this. Gets hit by 5K.
That's what happens when your game is too good on Oki.
Stomp, stomp, 2D. Watch the right, that's still plus. Hey, no punish. Actually, I don't think you can punish that version.
Oh no. Oh no.
He's dead. He would have been dead.
You should have killed him!
Woo! He's not dead, okay. There's moves going everywhere. They're just trying to hit each other.
My.
Uh-oh. He could lose here, alright?
He could lose.
Meaty Fireball. No knockdown. Overhead.
Rin, why?
He doesn't get a knockdown there.
Yeah, he missed the combo. He was trying to end with orb at the end and missed the combo, unfortunately.
The Kuyi was just like, I'm pressing buttons, bucko.
He shouldn't have even given him the chance to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You're Slayer and you see a blinking wrist bar. What do you do?
I'm a press button.
I'm a mash.
I'm a mash.
What's really cool is that I don't think either of these guys have backdashed more than once, so they had so much meter. They were just flinging out force breaks.
Like, I'm gonna hit you. All right, so Kuyi up 1-0. Wukash looked like he was kind of rusty, not sure what to do there. And then round two happened. He was like, oh, I'm on you. I'm just gonna go in.
It's more like, I feel like the way that people play Slayer are very different from one another, so it's like, maybe just need to adjust on the timings that Kuyi is playing at.
Bro, they both bursted already. What happened?
I'm not trying to get knocked down.
I mean...
I'm not trying to get knocked down.
Oh!
Alright. That was sick. If he meant that, that was sick.
Overhead blocked, okay. Backdashes away. Woo!
Woof.
That 2P, 5P barely hit.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, auto guard. Get that bat stomp out of here. Hey, Mappa.
Nice. Yeah, K hit Mappa. You're negative, so he presses buttons.
Stomp. And Mukash is just, try not to get hit by Pile Bunker.
Oh, time to start.
Whew.
Dandy, get out of the way.
No, confirm off the close S. Mappa,
oh!
BBU. Oh, wait, Slayer things are happening.
Yep.
Slayer things are happening. Don't burst.
Oh,
he's
no.
Dead.
Oh, he's no, trying to take his burst. His own combo.
Hey, jump K. Not dead. Hey.
Force break, Dandy. That was a utter mess in the corner.
Sloppy. But it worked out for Kuyi. I think Slayer is definitely one of those. I don't know how good of a scramble character you can compare him to, because if Slayer gets a certain type of hit and it's counter and you just balance off before, you're like, ah, I'm dead.
Yeah, the character itself is like, all of his counter hits just have an absurd amount of stun time or hit stun time, so it's like, you trade, it's always in Slayer's favor. You randomly run into JH, it's in Slayer's favor.
Because you bounce off the damn floor.
Yeah.
You're like, whoops. 50%.
It used to be that, like, counter hits used to be not based on, like, a certain amount of tech time, but, like, how far you were from the ground. Just like, yeah, you have to reach back up to here in order for it to fall out.
And then they were like, nope.
Yeah.
All right, who do we have up next? Because we once again, we have the C and D blocks, so if you're following along at home, you can type exclamation point B in the chat, and the brackets will come up. And you can see who's playing.
Or if you want more typing practice, you can just type out bracket.
Oh!
I mean, exclamation mark bracket works. The aliases are just for me, because I have to do it all the time.
Right. No, it's useful. I like that. Obviously,
people can use them as well if they want. But you know what we can check out right now?
Get it.
Matcherino. Back at it again. We have another campaign for this week. Currently it's $77. And okay. I have to check the stretch goals and make sure there isn't anything wild there.
It's just like, yeah, we're doing another tournament tomorrow.
Yeah,
like, it's like, all right.
But yep, and we have a promo code as well, so make sure that if you don't have any money of your own to contribute, that's okay. All you can have to do is pop over to the page and sign in with Twitch or Twitter or whatever, and pop that promo code in here, and you can add to the pot for free. Just takes a bit of time.
Yeah, and there's also all the quests on the sides as well for you guys to do.
Definitely. You can also check out the sponsor post over here on the sidebar. You can, you know, these are simple social media actions. You know, you can follow Red Bull on Twitch if you aren't already, and that adds 20 cents to the pot. Super quick and easy. So definitely, please, everyone, just take a few seconds and hit up the Matcherino. It'll really help things out. Definitely adds up over time.
Yeah, especially, like, we were amazed by the fact that we got to, like, 2,000 by the end of the night last tournament. But, like, that started with everybody, you know, from the beginning to the end. So it is really appreciated. Thank you, guys.
Phew. All right. I actually haven't seen the stretch goals yet. I hope they're not crazy again.
No, at $500, it's the top 8 payout.
Phew! Well, we can't even run another one of these next week anyway. We have to wait for the rollback.
Right, unless we, like... unless we did something drastic.
Nope. I know what you're thinking. Don't do it.
He put it out there already, though.
No, I'm just kidding. But up next, we're going to have Fiestament versus Green Tea. So it's going to be Testament versus Milia.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
See if I can find where that actually is in this Wumbo bracket. Okay, so this is actually to make it out of pool, whatever pool this is, D. So yes, this is a finals match. We're actually having pretty good time. It's only been an hour and a half.
Yeah, I think it's because everyone knows what they're doing, and two, matches are just going by. Practice, we're not waiting for too many matches. Yeah,
that is the case. You know, we have since this is like the run back to the tournament last week, everybody knows where to go, where to be. Right. There's no delays on that part.
So in other matches, we've got Black Snake versus GG Pui. Make it out of. Is the other match to make it out of Group D and winners.
Mm.
And over in Group C, we've got Googie versus Blitz Reloaded and KB Nova versus Krakatoa, which is going to be the match we have right after this.
Yes.
Get to watch KB Nova.
Kenji was like, I directly credit Kenji for like being one of the people who like really played a lot of games with me and sort of pushed me towards understanding the game better fundamentally. Because he's just like, one, insanely good as a player, but also two, like a super nice guy who's willing to do that with you.
And it does help that like a lot of people think that playing someone better than you just means you're wasting that person's time. That's not true at all.
Definitely.
people should realize that there is a learning experience to be had, and that if you can find someone who's a valuable teacher, you should cherish that, because not a lot of people, it's hard to be a good teacher.
Absolutely.
Plus, I think if even if the person you're playing against is way worse than you, it gives you an opportunity to try out things that you wouldn't really get to experiment with against a stronger opponent.
Yeah. Cool. Wow, actually dodged the warrant. That's crazy.
Uh-oh. Alright, so Green Tea was on a roll. He got hit in a corner. He was like, I need to burst so that way I don't have to play the Testament game.
Oof, nice pickup. Almost. Runway.
Yeah. Force break, Gravedigger. Overhead? Yeah. Time to guess. Oop. Gets hit by 2H. Overhead.
Yep, knock down. Curse to make sure Milia doesn't jump away.
Overhead. Oh, no.
Wow. What a block.
Okay, he's... Green Tea still has a lot of risk built up.
Stupid crow.
Counter hit. Almost picked it up.
He's trying to get meter. That burst.
Nothing.
Super?
Yeah!
Emerald Rain. Let's go.
That was really scrambly at the end, but that's because getting knocked down by either of these characters for the opponent is going to be frightening.
Ooh, here you go. Knocked down. Backdash. Rejump.
Oh, no. He fixed it up. Did not pick up pin, unfortunately, but he is in such a lead. He might not need it, especially with 50 or meter that he has right here.
Dead angle? No dead angle. Just blocks it out with FD. Gets hit by the overhead. Almost dead.
Yep.
Clean.
Yep. That's what I mean, man. That's the. It is so scary for both of these characters to get knocked down by the other, because they're both of their, either they're like Testament's neutral control and like air control is so good, and his buttons are so big that it makes it difficult for Milia to move around, and she doesn't have any defensive options for Barney's, as opposed to like Testament, who has like zero defensive options, and is just gonna get ran at the entire time.
Doesn't he have a counter? He has Warrant.
He has Warrant, but it's like, I don't know if Warrant like saves you from Milia mix-ups.
True, yeah. I mean, it can't hurt to try. Well, it can't hurt to try. You can just get mixed up again.
If she starts delaying stuff, yeah, Warrant becomes good in that situation. But like, I don't necessarily think Milia's do a lot of like delay. It's a lot of like mashing into like 6K or 2S or something like that.
Oof, jump D counter hit. Wake Ooh. Up, girl. All right.
Pick it up.
Knockdown.
Ooh, no, she's light.
Too high. So
she'll bounce higher than other characters.
All right, got pinned back. Thanks. Tries to 5H into a knockdown. The estimate faring a lot better this round so far. Ali does a throw. She gets a knockdown. Force break disc. Ooh. It's actually scary to dead angle when force break disc is on top of you because it hits three times. It can counter hit your dead angle.
Oh, that was so unfortunate. He actually got the hit there, Fiestament, and then wasn't able to convert it into a knockdown.
You gotta go real.
Yeah, you really need to, like, chain these knockdowns into one after another. I would say that's why Green Tea is, like, doing better in these matches so far. But he gets the hit, Badlands, a little bit too far to get the second in, so he sets up for the Oki.
He has meter. If he gets a hit, this round might be over. Yup.
Emerald Rain. Yup.
Damn, Green Tea's he's one round away from sending Fiesta with the losers.
Yeah, he almost got that. Brandstar Badlands, the classic.
Knock down overhead.
Oh no, he got him to get locked down. Crow helping out.
Reversal throw. Yeah. Oh, the web's still there. Rip.
No. All right, well he teched up and then got out, so it kind of worked out for him.
We got rejumps.
Knock down. 6H.
That was supposed to be force break this. He didn't realize he'd beat her. Time to guess. Counter hit. Oh no, here he dashed into the web.
Grave Digger. And then just got some room behind him. Oh no. That could have been worse.
Oy. No shake. Oh. No, he's dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Oh, he almost got it. There's a chance here. He has the meter to use it. Nope. Run up far S and Emerald Rain. Yep.
We hit confirm those. Thirst strike. Go.
Whew. Good stuff. That is, there's like some drops from Fiestament that really made that match more difficult than it needed to be.
Because Milia having access to just be able to fly it, even makes her life a lot harder because she has She has two air dashes, so if you block a normal and she hasn't air dashed yet, she can just do air dash, normal, air dash again, normal, and if you block low too fast, you get hit high, or she can just do air dash, empty jump, low, and you're just like, ah, yes, I see I got mixed. Yes.
Yeah. And also, like, there was that situation where Melia is like a light character, so situations where Badlands would normally knock down won't work on her. And that's pretty common for a lot of characters in Guilty Gear. Like, a lot of characters that need to use the wall or the air in some way to get their combos going, sometimes some combos don't work as well on lights.
All right, so Green Tea advances out into winner side of top 8, so he'll be waiting for that
green,
to start up.
Sorry, I was trying to kick Green Tea, but I have accidentally kicked both players.
Oh no!
Was one of them supposed to stick around?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the reason I was kicking is because it's a three-person lobby, so, like, wouldn't be able to get both players.
Oh, okay. Yeah, right. All right, next up, we got... This is the Krakatoa versus KB Nova match.
Yes, it is. Okay,
wonderful. Wonderful. I'm super excited. I wonder who he'll play, because he was... He played a lot of Zappa in Plus R, so I wonder if he's playing Zappa again. But he also had an Anji, and a little bit of a Kai. So he plays a lot for fun. So I wonder who he's actually gonna play.
It's tough because
I think it's just gonna be Zappa.
Yeah, you'll just go with what's comfortable with you, unless like you've been learning a character for a while, you're like, I want to learn this character in tournament, so that way I have this character in my back pocket.
Yeah. It'll probably be Zappa. He put a lot of work into that character, so.
Mm-hmm.
And at some point, he was probably the best Zappa in the United States for Plus R, even though that was probably like a year and a half long. It was still the case. It was that Northwest Major 6. He went really far in. Was it Northwest Major 6?
Was that the one where
we had Abigan and
Dogura?
Yeah, Dogura come out.
Yeah,
I believe that's the case. Yeah, where like Kenji had like those really really sick matches versus Abigan and Dogura. And actually, at some point, I think he switched back to Anji, and he was going ham a little bit. I remember all that. That was so long ago. Okay, right. Slappy from Pacific Northwest is confirming that, then I'm not crazy.
That was so long ago.
It was so long ago.
I know people are out here like, man, that was like a year ago? Yeah, that was like 10 years ago. It's like, whoa, hey, calm down. Hey, calm down there.
Yeah, I mean, we're talking about like releases for games and stuff like that, and people were like, you know, I was talking about when Exegol released, and it's like, yeah, I remember it got released? I'm like, yeah, in 2016. It's like, no, that was like 3 years before that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or 2 years, but.
Right, nobody look at the past right here. But...
don't you have like a scene for that?
I mean, I could also just like disable the game caption, but.
It's... Oh, that'll probably mess up something.
No, it wouldn't. I'm just lazy.
Hey, don't be rude.
Actually, do either of you know, if you if you leave private slots on, can people still join via password?
Yes, I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Okay, just double checking. Actually, I might have. Maybe I will actually turn that off real quick. Oh, what? It re-enabled? Oh my god.
Uh-oh.
Oh my god.
That's the Slayer Players combo right there. H, H, H.
Yeah, H, 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 H.
2H, jump H, RC, 6H. 2H, jump H, RC, jump H. I think that's enough.
Yep.
I think that works.
That's probably close.
Whew. Ugh. It feels weird to like to do commentary at home when it's like I still had to work like the, you know, X amount of hours, and it's like, oh yeah, this would be easy. I don't have to like go from my job to another building and then do commentary and then go home, and it's like, this feels almost as draining. This is weird.
Yeah, it's surprising, but like it is always like just the amount of talking gets you tired, which is surprising because I talk all the time. But now I'm using my brain, and I don't normally do that.
Actually, I see. Now that I'm thinking about it, how does this even work, right? Does it actually force you to pick a unique password, or?
You mean in terms of if you set it to private slots?
Right.
I think you can set. Yeah, you can set the. I don't know. Actually, I'm not sure because usually I just invite.
Yeah, I turn private slots on and just invite people. But that might be slightly harder because that means you'd have to have everybody on Steam, and that's annoying.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, definitely. Mm. Why can't these things be simple?
Not yet. We're getting there.
Soon.
We're soon. This is actually, the first.
I guess it's not even that it's not simple. It's that like every game does it differently, and you're like, okay, what's going on here?
Mm. Oh yeah, that's true. I don't think there's any way we're gonna get like conformity in this sort of thing, but it'd be nice.
So for everyone who is waiting with us, we're just trying to figure out how to get the lobbies to like not be
explodey.
Yeah, but it's you know, it's a beta, so things are gonna break, and we're lucky to have the game again for an additional week and a half.
2 weeks, yeah, because it's supposed to end on the 2nd.
Right. Damn, that was
11 days ago. Yeah.
That was okay. We take those, I guess.
We do take those. It's great. It's great. Now I feel like I don't have to play every single day.
Which is I was talking about that a while ago where. Sometimes stuff being exclusive to certain days makes it so that people feel like they have to play during the days that they normally have off. So it gives you more data about like who's playing where, how often disconnects happen and such.
Right. Because if let's say your weekend is like taken up already, then you're not going to get that data from those set amount of people. Yeah, so it is good. It is good that we get this for way longer. And I hope that the turnaround for having to getting it out of beta isn't too long, or they do another beta or something like that.
Right.
Because either way, it'd be fantastic just to be able to do these like monthly, so that way we don't have to like cram them all within like 3 weeks or something like that, or like be able to return to this every now and then, or for however long this hell is still frozen over, we'll get to be able to like play with each other with good netcode, which is super nice.
Because that does matter a lot. Like, I, given the ability to play people that I know on the West Coast with almost no, what feels like no latency, is great because it's like, hey, I can play this person who I know is really strong, and I get this matchup experience, and I can do that whenever I want. Feels amazing, as opposed to, well, I hope today no one's using Netflix, Hulu Plus, downloading torrents, has Spotify on all at the same time while I'm trying to play, you know, like a half hour's worth of matches. Because then you start making compromises with like how bad the connection is, and you're like, all right, I can't do this thing that I wanted to try.
Okay,
I can't do this thing.
I figured it out. This is actually, that's kind of whack. So if you have a lobby with a password and then you like disband it and you go to create a new one, you go through the settings, right? Mm-hmm. Like for the password setting, it says like pass, and like as opposed to like none, but it doesn't actually save the password that you use. So I don't know what that even means if you create that lobby. So just Because, like, you're telling it to use a password, but not giving it a password.
Mm-hmm.
That's making sense. But we got it. Let's do this match.
Mm.
Phew. Okay. Krakatoa versus KB Nova.
Please select your character.
I see Zappa.
Yep.
And Krakatoa, as we've seen earlier, still playing Faust. Alright, let's see how this goes. Once again, that we saw earlier, I believe we saw it was A3 versus Krakatoa. Was it A3 versus Krakatoa? Am I crazy?
It was A3 versus Zappa, right?
No, he was a Zappa player.
Sorry.
Or was it Venom?
I think it was him versus Venom. It was A3 versus Roldy. That's right.
Roldy.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to figure out, like, okay, how does Zappa do in this matchup? Because, you know, Faust has the ability to throw out items. He has the range, but Zappa also has the range given the correct summon.
Yeah. Like right I here. Imagine that dog is like a huge pain in the ass. I imagine all the summons are really bad because of his body, right? Like Ghost makes it difficult to move around. Sword Lockdown is like incredibly difficult for him to deal with. He doesn't have fast buttons to sort of deal with dog pressure.
Ooh, knockdown, very easy. Kenji out here, bro.
Why is Kenji still good? I don't understand.
Because when you play a game for a long time against high level players in a fairly small vacuum, you will have to flourish. You either perish or you flourish. It's one of those two. Krakatoa is just like, I don't want any. Get that dog away from me.
Yeah, now dog pressure. Dive.
Whew. Oh, too far.
Yeah.
Unsummoned though.
He might have just missed the dash up or something.
Hitbox interactions.
Hey, that's a big reversal throw in the corner.
When did that bomb get there? What the hell?
We lagged a little bit.
He got another bomb. What the hell?
School of Elven Shadow. Item tossing.
Alright. King Noah has decent life lead. Oh, that's the slowest air throw on earth. My goodness. Hey.
Oh.
Ooh, that burst is almost tragic.
Yeah.
Hey, wow. Go burst.
Toss it. Peace. Do it again.
I'm so surprised
we didn't do it again.
Whew.
Oh my god, there's two dumbbells.
He's not dead. Whew. FRC. Sword pressure. Hey.
Yeah, he's just going to special over and over again.
Let's go. All right, so Kenji taking game one.
Yeah, this is crazy. How many good players are there?
Oh, there are actually a lot. There's actually a lot of good players.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, we're seeing, like, you know, players that made our top eight last time having trouble in pools. Although I guess this is like winner's finals in the pool, so.
Mm. Oh, so winner just gets out to top eight. Yeah. Winner side.
Yes.
Top 16.
But there are a lot of really strong plus R players because that, like, all those years of not having, you know, another Guilty Gear to play, it's you just like, I like Guilty Gear, so I'm gonna keep playing this one that I have.
Like Third Strike?
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, that was the case, like, for the most part, all those people who loved Guilty Gear just kept playing Guilty Gear. Because they're just like, there's no other game like this, not even close.
Mm-hmm. All right, round start. Just zap a backdash. Peace, bye, goodbye. Oh, dog.
Oh, wait, good reversal throw. Uh-huh.
Okay. Oh, my turn. Air throw, OTG, yep.
Oh, he tried to sandwich. He spent the gold burst not to get sandwich. He did not care what would happen with it. Just no thank you.
But the dog's still there. Oh, it's gone now.
Uh-huh. Flower, what going my name? Way. Toss. No, wait, he had food down there.
Alright. Kenji has sword. Peace. Hey, Robokai though. Mini Robokai. What is that move called? The special move with the sword where he just flips.
The one where he's spinning or
yeah.
Remind me of remember all the sword name moves.
I barely know, like, two. Alright. Ooh, wake up summon. Cross up. Hey, block this.
Alright, so Kenji's probably gonna like stick it out with this summon right here unless he decides to spend meter to get an overhead for an unsummon. Peace!
Oy.
Gold Burst, oh no!
Gold Burst, item toss, do it!
Force break door. Chopped.
Oh, force breaks, god!
He has force
breaks. House players, I swear to god.
Force break chop. Hey, fuck it. Wait, wow, that works like that? Okay, fuck it. Okay, that's Robokai. I couldn't tell what summon that was, so I was like, where is he? Hey, anti-air dog. Time to guess.
Oh no, the sandwich. Oh, nice block on the overhead. Oh no, no thank you.
Good dog. Faust is like, hey, can I pet the dog? Zappa's like, nah, get out of here, bro.
Ooh. Oh no. Alright, space that with 2H.
Bomb. Alright, so Kenji's keeping the space. Hey, we take those trades. Got some way back. FRC, yeah.
Oh, nice! And he jumped away from Chibi Robokai.
Whew. Keeping him locked down. What?!
Oh my god, what was that throw?
I think he aired through Scalpel. Air Scalpel.
Yeah, I think so too.
Cause I saw him swimming and I'm just like, I hear the noise, I'm like, wait.
And then, yeah, nothing.
I'm like, is that... Zappa doesn't have any air EX moves, he just air threw him. Phew. Alright, good stuff to KB Nova. Hopefully we see more of him in top 8.
I think that's top 16 he qualified to, right?
No, isn't it top 8 he qualified to?
I don't know how far this bracket's going. Is it top 16 or top 8? Am I wrong?
I'm pretty sure it's top 16.
Oh, it's top 16, my bad. Oh yeah, you're right, my bad.
Because there's two out in winners and be two out in losers per group.
Okay. Gotcha. Who else do we have left in this Fiestament? And Jace is still in losers. They're playing to qualify. We have Wukash and Krakatoa now. That's the qualifying match. That should be busted good. AKA is waiting for the loser of Kugi versus Blitz. We got Hano and Monkeys in winners.
Yeah, no.
Qualifying. That should be sick as well.
I think they're playing now.
Oh, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, I think they're on the other stream because we're broken up into two groups. So right. Arturo's probably got the other... He's probably got the Yeknam Hano.
Oof. Hey, yeah, Bruchin. That should be good.
Hey, Bruchin.
Hey. And then we have... Over on their side, too, they also have Kaylee versus Fu.
Mm. Oh, damn. Fu might make the top 16. Let's go.
Top 16. I want to see some Fu. Fu is so much fun to watch. I really hope he makes it. Not to be biased, SoCal, let's go. But, like, he's just super fun to watch as a player.
Because he has ideas.
Yes. I was about to say he's a grappler player, so he has ideas. He's a grappler player that has, like, isn't afraid to move beyond being a grappler player. You know, so he's like a daywalker. it's like Deb, right? Like, she's used to be a grappler player, and then she started playing Soul.
I mean, what are you talking about? Soul's still a grappler.
I mean, yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're right. Which is frightening, by the way, because grappler players usually stick to grappler style characters and then they venture off with their ideas into the unknown. Frightening.
They know what the unknown is known to them. They just want to make sure that the unknown to you is unknown, not unknown to them.
Unknown to them. They know grappler players can only see 2 inches in front of them. That is it. That's why they bulldog everything.
That's most grappler players, though.
And then they decided that one day they were just gonna run head first into the void and they're not afraid. Those people are frightening.
Oof.
Speaking of frightening, they have real Wokai on the screen. That's one of those characters where, like, if you've never fought Robokai extensively or have no knowledge of him, you just get steamrolled, because once he gets level 3 heat, almost all his normals are just incredibly plus, and you're just like, what's happening? Oh, 6B.
Oh, no.
But Robokai is heavy, Venom gets some of his better combos on him. Oh. And the burst, Zero's like, nah, I'm out here, bro. Hey! He gets the automatic follow-up with the DP if he has 50 meter. Hey, command grab. He might kill him off. Yep.
Yeah.
So Prucha kind of having a hard time because Robokai has a little bit of extra air movement. Oh god. Then he has jump H.
Yeah, he also has good buttons and good control of the horizontal range in front of him, so it's difficult for Venom to even get started.
Uh-oh. Ooh, in the corner. He's... I believe he's close to exploding, but he might not decide to cool down. Hey! Ooh, 6P in that air?
Yeah, now he is. Oh boy. Oh
Belly
boy.
Wake up?
Nope.
Hey! DP automatic follow-up because he has meter. Dead angle. Ooh, tricky. Oh no, he has no burst. Time to get mixed. Just kidding. Oh. Blocking missiles is always a hazard.
Yeah. You right, got meter there. Whew. Whoa. 6H tipper.
Oh, Prucha keeps jumping. I was about to say jumping with his missiles and he got hit. Wait.
Oh!
Wait!
Yo, EX or Superset? What a monster!
2D low profile in the burst. Hey, 6H though.
I forgot Superset was a thing.
Yeah. He calls it and then it's like, oh god, oh no, I have to deal with all the extra lightning balls. I think they hit three times, each of them?
Yes, so, each of them hit three times.
So they just fly around the screen, you're like, I guess I got a block.
Actually, so for the uninitiated, how does Robokai's meter work?
Okay, so Robokai doesn't actually get meter normally. He has to set a mat on the floor, and then he has to stand on the mat in order to get meter. So he doesn't get meter by moving forward or anything like that. That's the only way that he gets meter. He can also dash. He has a move that's a dash, and then if he gets a hit, he can go into a canned animation and get meter that way.
So that mat that he has there, it helps him get meter, but also his meter is affected by how often he's attacking and getting hit and blocked.
Yes. So also the second thing is that a lot of his moves get powered up by using one block. So missiles will spread out if he has a block. That rocket becomes way, way, way more plus with it. Stuff like that.
And he has levels of heat because as you see how red he is right now, I believe that's level 2. When he's like glowing red, that's level 3, and almost all of normals once again are plus like crazy. So it's hard to contest him sometimes when he's frame trapping you. Whew. Alright, Zero gets out.
Oh, D-Missile!
Hey. Yeah, regular missiles are hard to contest because if you don't run under them fast enough and clear them, they'll break up and get to you on the other side, or you're just stuck blocking the one big missile. Hey, possible ghost. And you can see Prucha just trying to make sure that Zero can't really get out the corner freely. Nope.
Oh, tried to get a combo there.
Uh-oh. Hey, reversal throw. Burst. Yeah, Zero's just like, screw it. Had enough. Hey.
Oh, 5H. Charge it up. Oh my god, he is blinking!
Time to block. Plus.
Oh no.
Holding this again. Where's your meter, man?
Where's
the meter?
He almost died off that too. That'd have been crazy.
Oh,
not enough to chip. Oh no. Chance.
Wait, can you counter hit self-destruct?
He was glowing off his wrist gauge. Oh my god, this does so much.
Right.
Holy shit.
Counter hit. So explosion. Or self-destruct. Not self-destruct. Overheat. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Overheat. Mm-hmm. Overheat is a hit onto yourself, and he was blinking from wrist gauge.
So I think it still counts as a counter hit. So he just floats.
Ooh, jump S.
So weird.
Alright, guess another setup. Double hit, bada hit. Alright, Pusha's just like, alright, I'm chilling.
Yeah. And he does actually need to go at Robokai because you can just 2D mat and sit in game meter while he's setting up the shmup.
Uh-oh, he didn't block the rock successfully. So that's to keep blocking. Oh my god.
The best Venom player in the world! He's the best!
Red Hail.
No one in their right mind would ever use Red Hail unless you're the best in the world.
This checks out, yes. This does check out.
Oh, that was a really good match, though.
It looked like Black Snake was having an issue not getting tagged by certain Robokai normals, because they are pretty obnoxious. Yeah. Like his jump H, jump S, 5H, 6H, the heat, the steam, it gets bigger the more heat levels he has. So if he's blowing red and he does 6H, the smoke is black and it's super plus and it hits way in front of him. So fighting Robokai is also one of those like knowledge checks, like, okay, I see him glowing this much, like I have to watch out for these things, etc. Hey, that angle. Time to guess.
Alright, just backs up.
Hey!
Flip underneath there, get the dash, go in the animation, get the meter.
Ooh. Try to move too early. Aye, that did a lot of chip.
Yeah.
Plus, finger FRC.
Oh my god!
Thanks, the Lele Cook.
Yeah.
Alright, he might be able to kill here if he gets a clean hit. Yep, should be able to FRC. Oh, not even.
Oh,
yeah, he planned it.
That was sick.
Oh no.
Damage.
He tried to air dash, he got hit by 6P.
Nope.
Wow. Close S hit so high up.
Uh-huh. Launched. Knocked down.
Alright, so Black Snake. Wow, that's 6P. Tried to bait the burst again.
Yeah, don't drop don't burst close S.
Ever.
Yeah, that's a rule.
Uh-oh.
Oh hey.
Uh-oh. Woo. He jumped out. Hey. Ooh, no 5D
for you. That ball is still moving, goddamn. Wait, Matt struggle. He'll take that trade because it puts him back in neutral. The gold burst!
He panicked because he was like, I'm gonna die.
Yeah. Oh no.
Oh, he's 6P too early.
Slow missile.
I hate that missile too, because when it like it stops moving forward, it just drops. It's like the most obnoxious hitbox to get around.
Oh, trade. Oh, wow.
Knocked down. Set Matt. Just trying to control the space. Pusha finds some room, but not just to get thrown.
Slide again. Knockdown.
These trades are not in his favor, though. He does not have as much health as Robokai.
Ooh, jumps over the dash. Puts zero into the corner. Stays plus. Oh my god, don't get counter hit. Okay.
That could have been it. Oh, the Bristle delay throw from the set.
Alright, hold this corner pressure. Ooh, let's go. Hey, reversal throw. This time. Singer?
Maybe he meant to FRC that.
Yeah.
I think he's trying to get out of this corner. Oi.
Oi.
How much damage he's done just by. Oh no, super set.
Oh my god, he almost died.
He actually almost died.
Ah!
Oh my
god. Ah! He's fighting the missiles. Ah, that burst is terrible.
Oh my god, this is second terrible burst.
Oh no. You win. He was actually killing the missiles. That was crazy.
He had a massive life lead. What the hell?
And then he got tagged by 4 different stinger aims.
That's a lot. I didn't think that was that many. Then you said 4. I'm like, that's a lot. That's a lot of damage adding up.
Yeah. Pruchas. I'm so glad that you used the superset. It's so silly.
Yeah.
It is actually such an absurd amount of potential damage because of the way that the balls work.
Because they hit three times each, so if you have a proper formation, you can kind of like do closest hits twice, jump cancel, one of the balls hits two times, go back in, do the same thing again, and just put them full screen and get a knockdown. It's really silly. You gotta be a wizard, as they say, to do that.
He keeps doing the same formation, the one that sets it up in a pentagram. I wonder if there's a good reason for that. Because you do have different formations for it.
Maybe it's because I think once he does a stinger, I think the stinger breaks them up so they hit almost everywhere. So if you try to run, you have to block at least one if you jump a certain way.
Because there's like there's the P formation, which is like the less than sign. That was the, like, when I was first seeing people really mess with it, I saw a lot of that one, and I saw a lot of, there's the, hold on, I'm gonna look it up. I'm too stupid for this. the KD formation, which is just the cross. I saw a lot of that, but I haven't seen a lot of people use the S formation like he is.
Oh, they're ready. Oh god, that's fast. So, Blitz Reloaded versus Kugi. Hey, Slayer Milia.
It's the most well-rounded formation for it. Interesting, okay. Interesting. I never thought of it that way. It's just like, it just has the ability to control the most space with the way that he can hit the balls. Okay, very cool. I guess I mostly saw like setups and stuff like that where you'd go like do stuff like do a normal setup, knock down into ball set, and then try to do some crazy nonsense.
All right, here we go. This is the matchup where as Milia, you're like, please God, don't get hit by jump H, and it just happened.
He was thankfully jumping back, so
he's almost dead. Hello? He got comboed twice.
He has meter, by the way.
Oh, he's about to let it rip.
Do it. Hit him in the mouth.
Oh. Kugi?
Kugi.
It's okay. He's going to do wake up, force break dandy, and get out and win.
He should have.
Ooh, that didn't hit. Knock down the right way. That sucks. Alright. So Blitz Reloaded has still fairing pretty well. Oh god, got hit.
Mm-hmm. Relaunches. Yeah, he's got... He did it!
He did the thing!
This is a bunch of kids in the classroom looking at Slayer like, do the thing, do the thing!
Yeah! That was a good air throw from Blitz. Knockdown roll. You gotta be really careful with Slayer flying around like that. Ooh, blocks the overhead, plus backdash. Oh no, we got counter hit for doing a hair car.
Ooh. Two. Ooh. Oh no, don't want to burst there. No, thank you.
He lives though.
Yep.
Oh no, Slayer time. Wait,
sick. I think we just skipped some frames.
It's fine though.
Yeah.
Because unless Kugi like throws us away somehow, he's got this in the bag. Because Milia has no HP right now. Oh,
he has,
no.
But he has no meter. That's the problem. He has zero meter right now.
Please don't burst poorly.
From the months of getting hit. All right, there you go.
Swap forward, yeah. You build a lot of meter, though. This is crazy.
He got hit by jump D. Oh, he tried to press buttons.
He tried to press buttons.
Alright, oh god, Blitz is already in the corner. Imagine being pressured in the corner without blocking anything.
It's frightening, man. It's just a bunch of hitboxes.
I don't want to interact with those, get me out of here.
Ooh. Lockdown, H-disc.
Ooh. What's the second normal?
Very cool. Do it again.
I hate that
so much.
But it's cool though, the FRC from the whiff the sword car.
Yeah, I mean it is cool. In the it would be cooler if she didn't have force breaks in like other tools, but
Oh, not enough meter to finish him off there, 2P? I mean, Slayer's still alive, so this is terrifying. He has so much meter.
Do it. Murder! Woo! Oh, wow, how'd he go the other way? That was crazy.
Uh-oh. Locks the overhead. Tries to move after. Oh, God. Oh, all right, Kugi has 25 meter. Chillin'.
Oh, no! Oh, she's light. You have to change your combos.
That jump page hit.
Full loose journey actually ruined. Ah! The fucking jump H!
Bro, alright, so...
H button!
So, we all saw that Slayer was pretty high in the air when he did that jump H, right? And then... Milia pressed 2P like, oh, I'm safe. I got this. And then, the thing with the hitbox is the jump H and was like, hey, are you down there? No. Okay, cool.
H! You just give him one of these.
If Fly Girl giving you some okie mix-up, you give him one of these.
Oh, God.
I need someone to make that edit.
Round Star Classic.
Oh, doesn't get the air dash.
Oh, God. He literally just mashed H. What a monster.
All right. Into the corner you go, Slayer.
Oh, wow. Secret Garden?
Yeah, I didn't think he had enough time to do that.
Yeah, me neither.
Oh. Ooh, no combo off the 6K. No throw for you. No force break for you.
I totally forgot her dead angle was close S in this game.
What is it in Exit?
I believe it's 6P.
I think you're right. Yeah. Oh, God. Plus. Peace.
I have never seen that. Nice confirm, though.
He's dead.
That was sick.
He tried to commit murder.
It used to be close S and Exert, and then they changed it. That's right. You are correct. Thank you.
From Sign Brain.
Yeah. They changed it because that shit's stupid.
Close S hitting so high. That's a bit angle. Ooh, let's go. Just got first seed, being cool.
Oh my God.
All right, go first.
Oh man, the hitbox reaches the heavens.
That angle again. Time to guess. Kugi burst. He's like, I had enough. Bro, why didn't he hit like that?
It's not called Big Bang sideways. It's called Big Bang upper.
Upper. I mean, the sideways thing is the wait. Oh, okay. They're chilling. Okay. I thought there was a desync. Oh no, 2H. Woo. Yeah, Kugi's staying on the other side of the screen. He's like, yeah, you can't knock me down if I don't get close to you. But then I can't kill you if I don't get close to you. I have a dilemma. Right.
That was a bit of mashing. Oh my God.
No pickup.
He could have killed if he got the RC. Just reset into pressure, though.
Phew. All right,
Big bang upwise.
That's point. No, big bang up, stupid. Ooh, he was trying to bait backdash cancel there. Oh no!
Oh no.
Okay, it wasn't too late.
No, do the cool thing!
Oh, Kugi not blocking S disc.
Ooh, let's go! Let's go! Woo! Oh, he missed it. That was mostly sick.
Oh no, he's about to die. Kugi tried to OTG throw his burst. He's gonna do it again, watch. Oh, tried to bait it again. Hey, 2D. Am I too close to you? I'm gonna do 2D anyway because you're gonna press a button because you're scared.
Kugi toxic for mashing 2D. Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
What are you talking about? He has a perfect spacing because he knows you're gonna press buttons on 2D because you think he's gonna do backdash cancel so you're gonna mash.
Oh man.
That's the mix-up.
I think Blitz wins, by the way, for the amount of games I've seen. From a single.
Oh my God, that's 2400.
That's 2400.
Yikes. Well, not yikes in a bad way. It's yikes like damn.
Awesome. Yikes in a bad way. Absolutely. Love yourself, Blitz. Don't. No, thank you.
So top 16 is tomorrow? Absolutely not.
No, we're not doing that. We don't do that here.
No, we were running straight through this.
You must be new here, Hano.
Yeah, I think top 16. Let's see. Oh, yeah, that's right. It's challenge, so I don't think it'll even let us start top 16 matches until we finish out everything. So.
Alright.
But we have what I believe is the last match.
Ooh.
Before top 16. If I can find it in this humongous bracket. But right down here, losers round 7. Blitz Reloaded, we will be getting back on stream.
Are they going to do a million mirror?
AKA FGC.
Oh, no. No, wait. He might play Eddie.
He might play Eddie.
That actually
is. He plays a bunch of... I know AKA plays a bunch of characters, but he primarily switches between Eddie and Milia.
Yes,
but
yes.
It's been a while since I've seen him play.
Yeah, I don't know what he's playing mostly, but I imagine Milia just because the character's far easier to get back into, and it's still super good in this version of the game. But he really enjoyed playing Eddie, so I don't, either one will be fine.
Vaughn just struggling with this bracket. All right,
it's a big bracket.
Big bracket.
She got a big bracket, so I call her Big Bracket.
Alright, looks like Blitz needs a few minutes, which gives us some time to talk about
the Matcherino.
Matcherino.
Woo!
But you guys should talk about it. I'm gonna do stream things, I don't know.
We have this crazy thing. It's legit magic. It's called Matcherino, alright? So have you ever tried to make something out of nothing? It's impossible. Not today, folks. Today we have Matcherino, where you can create money from literally doing nothing except for clicking a couple links. So you go down here, you go to Matcherino, going on the side. If we haven't used up the promo code already, then you then put in the promo code. You give us a 50 cents. If you want to give us a little bit more, you can like follow some people that are aligned with Matcherino, and they will give us like slightly more money for every one of those, which is awesome because it is no money to you. It's basically just free, which is awesome.
Yeah, that's crazy. All you have to do is click two or three things, and all of a sudden it's like, hey, I've donated $2 to this pot that I like because I think these players deserve a little bit of money for their trial and tribulations. And they also provided me free entertainment. Even though it's not technically free because you have the internet, you have to have your own personal computer of some kind or even your phone, then you have to have a place to live, and then you have to have food, you gotta have clothes, you gotta have a bed, but you get what I'm trying to say.
Jesus, I'm
stressed.
Life
isn't free, and neither is the stream.
There you go.
My time is very valuable.
But the Matcherino is free.
Yeah.
For you, which is nice. But if you guys also want to contribute a little bit more, there's things to buy on there as well, and proceeds will go towards the prize pool, which is nice.
Yeah.
Either way, we appreciate it. Thank you guys very much.
And also special thanks to NYC Furby with the $21.03.
Hey, weird amount. Thanks, Arturo.
Yeah, but thanks, Art. Lunar Phase, that's us. Whoa. With $11.86. Ooh, Mr. K, yo, what's up? With $20 plus the promo code. Monta with $20 plus the promo code. And Igar with $10. Again, remember, folks, it just takes some time. All you have to do is hop on over to the page, hit contribute after you sign in. Pop in that promo code, easy peasy. While you're here, I got the sponsor quest over on the sidebar. Super simple social media actions that you can take that will also add free money to the pot.
And you can also, there is a link that has the multi-stream, so in case you're like, I don't know where the which matches are being held where, you click on the multi-stream down there and you will have access to both streams at the same time.
Yep,
without right having to flip between
winners. We have two streams today. Top 16 winners will be on NYC Furby. Top 16 losers will be here. And then all of top 8 will be on NYC Furby.
Arturo saving us from having to stream for another like 3+ hours, so yeah. God bless him.
Bless his soul.
Yep. Because I remember you did this last week. I felt absolutely drained. And I'm like, whoa, what happened?
Yeah, and this was the short stream.
Yeah. Quote, unquote.
Quote, unquote, short. Yeah. Like, oh, yeah, it was like 4 hours last week.
It had been so long since I had done like a 4 hour block in a row. And like last week, I was dead freaking tired afterwards. Yeah. Cause all of my commentary stamina is gone. It is out the door.
Bro, didn't you do... Oh, wait, you didn't do any commentary for netplay tournaments?
Not yet, no.
Damn, you gotta fix that, bro.
But even... It's not up to me.
I mean...
I don't think people know I exist anymore. I just yell super... Like, listen, I was like 3 years into like doing commentary regularly, and I showed up on streams, and people are still like, who the hell's this guy? All right, so it's like the fact that I get to talk about games at all is fine. I'm happy.
Nah, bro, you need to go up to whoever runs Level Up and be like, yo, you know these games that I like? You should. I'm not asking to be hired. I'm asking that if I could just do them.
Working without getting paid. That's crazy.
Yeah, I know. It's something else, isn't
Listen,
it?
Listen, man, we've evolved. It's 2020.
Bro, it's 2020 and we can't leave our houses comfortably, okay? Like, working for free is...
Frightening.
Unfortunately, it's something we still kind of have to do, but it's for the greater good, you know? Because people have faith in us to do commentary because they like our commentary.
What?
Yeah, I know, it's crazy, right? I can't believe anyone likes my commentary.
Bro, I don't do any... I just yell.
I just yell as well, bro.
I just yell and laugh.
I wish we could pay everyone. I wish you could pay me.
Yeah, you should be getting paid for this. Not us. You should be getting paid.
But no, at least with online tournaments, it's easier to not be negative for the tournament.
Yeah, having to travel, having to buy more equipment.
Yeah, the travel is the thing. For... Like, it's raining. I'm like, oh, yeah, I'll take a cab.
Ugh.
But and a few expenses when you don't have to go anywhere, at least.
Yeah, that part's really nice.
Yeah. Oh, phew.
Yeah, sorry for the hold up. Just giving Blitz another moment to let themselves or like take the dog outside or whatever.
Right.
Happen. Generally, ideally, we wouldn't make players play again immediately in losers after losing a winner's match. But it's pretty much the only match that we have left.
Hmm. Oh, okay. Gotcha.
Wait, hold on. So, wait, aren't you playing on LK stream right now?
Wait, what?
Wait, what?
That's the other thing about online tournaments. When it's an offline tournament, you have everyone there. Like, you can't be in, like, two tournaments.
I distinctly, like, I remember when this started happening a lot, or, like, online tournaments for other games. I remember watching people play Dota, like, in tournaments online, get done with, like, a set, which is, like, a best of three, and it's, like, every game takes like an hour, and then there's picks and bans and like the breaks of the, so it's like a 3 hour set sometimes, right? And those dudes waiting for their next game, which will happen in 3 hours from now, just queue up for solo queue. Whew. Right afterwards.
I would not want to play immediately after again doing so many 3 out of 5s.
Yeah. Legit, just those like people who just like are like, yeah, I'm done with my tournament, it's time to play games again. Those people are monsters.
Yeah. Because you're going from a controlled environment of 5v5 teams to I'm playing solo queue, someone's gonna feed and it ain't me.
MOBAs or something else, definitely not for me. It takes you how long to lose?
At the minimum, if you're lucky, 15 minutes. If you're unlucky, like anywhere between a half hour to 40 minutes. If you're unlucky.
And that's League.
Yeah, that's League. Dota like, doesn't have Abandon.
I'm getting Which bodied. Is... I want to take like 30 seconds.
you can probably do that. That's you can probably do that, but not really.
You can do that. The rest of your team can't. Yeah, but you can do that.
No, I wouldn't abandon my team. Not like that.
No, what you do in Dota is when you have a bunch of teams of players who are going to be shitters, you just start farming for the rest of the game. You just run into the jungle. Never come back.
You just go into a lane and you're like, all right, this is my lane now. I'm going to farm until I get my items.
God, one day we're going to have talks when we're old about our old Dota games. And I'm just going to sound like the biggest, oldest man. God.
Oh, wait, they're playing. Oh, God. Okay,
yeah.
All right.
Yeah, we do actually have a match now.
Nice. It is Millia versus Eddie.
All right, he's playing Eddie.
And of course, it's this song.
Because it's good. This is a matchup we actually saw a lot because these characters are really prevalent in AC. And AKA also plays both these characters, so I imagine he knows quite a bit on how to approach it.
Oof, there goes half her life.
Nope.
Oh, 6p into air though. Time to block out though. Oops. Oh, it's okay. We have Force Break Disc comes out almost immediately. Yeah. Oh no, drill lockdown. Burst, get off me. Hey. To us, get away from me. No pin for you. Hey, we moving.
Mm.
He might mercy up.
Yeah. Boy. That's close.
This is trying to run.
Skills. Yeah, he's just trying to waste time for Eddie.
The best.
Jump game. Can he pick it up? No, not quite. Rising jump S.
Uh-oh. This might be over.
Oh. Yeah. Hey. He got chipped out, actually.
All right, round two. Hair car.
Yep.
Probably trying to snipe little Eddie, but no dice. 2D gets a knockdown. Doesn't get the hairpin back. Oh, he tried to throw. He's got a block now.
Ooh, got a gold burst too. Eddie has a really lot of interesting uses for meter, but they're all just gonna end up being skills. So. It'll be interesting to see if he actually has something else to use this for.
Exhaustion? Nope, just skills.
No, it's just skills.
I thought he was going to do it again, honestly.
Other Eddie players would have.
IAK running down Blitz. To be. That's a guilty gear throw.
Yeah. He had all of his air throws were real sick.
I think that's the coolest thing to me in any anime game is if you can get like the super low to the ground air throw off.
Yeah. Actually, fun fact, in SG, if you do your air throw like low enough to the ground, you can cancel into ground specials.
Jesus.
That's neat.
Jesus.
Can as in you have the ability to, or are you? Can you not do like air normals or air throws, air stuff?
Like can as in it considers you grounded.
Oh, okay, gotcha. All right, that's still pretty cool.
It's actually just like a overall thing in the game. If you're in the air and you're low enough to the ground, it like considers you grounded.
Ooh. All right, Blitz still doesn't get his pin back, but he has a pretty good life lead.
Provided. Yeah, and he's got meter. Oh. Drops it.
Nah.
Doesn't matter. Force break this. Saves the day.
And you're dead. 2k throw. It's really hard to want to press buttons on Millia when she has so much meter because then it's like force break this comes out instantly.
Yeah.
And any trade is usually in her favor because it hits three times. Mm-hmm. Alright. No pin. No regen.
Oh, no knockdown, yeah.
Oh, drill hit. Oh, boy. Ooh, good back dash.
Caught him with the 6H. He is doing well to like control the airspace. Oh, exhaustion! Let's go!
Got hit by Nobiru.
It is weird seeing exhaustion in neutral, let me tell you.
Ooh.
Oh, Eddie got kicked as soon as he used exhaustion, so he actually lost the meter and the character. Or in the shadow.
Alright, Blitz is being a lot more proactive now. He's really trying to make sure AK doesn't like get a drill.
Oh no! Oh, could have been worse. Could have been worse, but he didn't get knocked down.
Hey, late air dash MK.
Pick it up.
Yeah. You don't burst Millia there.
Yeah, 5k is like the easiest burst punish in that situation too. It's fast, it's easy, it goes into whatever you need it to do.
It also recovers it, like,
instantly.
Yeah, because when you burst there, once she does 5k, she kind of just retracts her hurt box a little bit, and she leans, she's like, she leans away.
So Kirby 1-1?
Yes.
Okay. I blinked in the match ended.
That's what it's like sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, this is why this matchup was actually super interesting back when it used to be really prevalent in AC, because both these characters have no life, and both these characters have the ability to keep you locked down the entire time. It's really, really scary to like play for both characters.
Okay. Last game coming up here for both of them. Bring back special intros.
Please! Please bring back special intros. Good God, they're so cool.
Ooh, damn, that pin hit. Oh, trying to get the pin, got hit by Drill. It's not blocking Drill for some reason, besides the burst.
Oh, I got the pickup too.
Whoops. It was a reset. Right. Cool.
Yeah. Still doesn't have pin, at least. He picked it up last time.
Yeah,
I mean, this is still getting really messy, but like Blitz have found a way to convert that into something else every single time.
Baited the throw, should get the kill here. He has a bunch of meter. OTG. Nope, not enough. Air dash, whiff jump, K throw.
Yep.
Alright.
Wow, just using the jump 2H in neutral like that in there.
Blocks. Hey, here, car. Time to guess.
Uh huh. Resets the pressure. Just gets the throw again. That's been working consistently.
Oh, late burst.
Yeah, just get out of the corner. We're leaving the pin back there.
Ah.
Oh, I think he used Secret Garden to try to get it. Yeah, he got it. There it is.
Oh, cross it, counter hit too. Can't hit it again, he's trying to press buttons.
Nice block.
Last chance though.
Yeah.
Jump K, jump K, 5K, ooh. Dead angle. Still doesn't have the bloody back. Oh, Secret Garden. Oh no.
He tried. He was like, once he was in Break the Law, it was like kind of no good solution there.
Part of me was just like, where's the YRC? I'm like, oh yeah, it's, oh yeah.
Yep. Yep.
It ain't there.
Good. She's least, stupid.
I mean, I will be real. Break the wall YRC and XR, it's kind of really dumb.
It's mega ultra dumb. I'm not a fan of it.
Me neither, honestly. I mean, at least they made it so that in, I think it was in Red 2, where if you put a normal on top of the YRC, he gets counter hit.
I think so, yeah. I don't remember. I just remember people stopped doing it, and I was like, thank God.
Oh, that's because Zato got gutted, kind of.
Good. I have no sympathy for Zato and Eddie players. No, thank you.
Damn.
Y'all had your time in the sun for far too long. Far too long.
Yeah, they were going kind of ham-do.
No, thank you. You guys spent like a year in not top tier life of plus R, and then immediately went back to the best character in the game in Sign.
And then Elfo came out, and then he was still like top two, top three, free. Because I remember that people were like, oh, Elfo's not a great character, and like, within the first like few months, we were just like,
That was actually one of the weirdest phenomenons I think I had experienced in fighting games in a while, where Japan just said no to the DLC characters being good.
Yeah,
that just was there, like what, like Sin's busted, and like everybody's like, no, Sin sucks. And we're just looking like, what the hell is happening?
Yeah,
there?
Like, bro, what? This character is clearly like S tier. Because what was it? Elkhunt was like zero if you... No, it was like plus one and you had to IB it to make it minus.
Yes. I recall something like that.
And it forced you to learn how to IB because that character would just stay in if you couldn't do it properly.
Yeah, Elk Hunt was plus two. Oh my god.
Yeah, I don't miss that. I don't miss that at all.
Forward moving low that hooked you up on counter hit.
Oof.
That's plus.
Get me out. Get me out.
In low profile things.
Yeah, definitely always crazy to me the differences that you see between US and Japanese tier lists,
which I think is what I like it because I like the correlation of opinions based off of regions and player strengths, because there could be a really super strong Ramothal player who can have a completely different tier list from another super strong Ramothal player because they're just like, I think these matchups suck because X, Y, and Z, and they'll be like, I don't agree with that because you can do the X, Y, and Z in these matchups. And like, it becomes opinionated sometimes, and you need to have the whole community come together and say like, okay, this is what we all think, or based off the numbers, because you know sometimes they do like matchup chart, like is a matchup 5-5, 6-4, etc. And based off the numbers, you're just like, okay, these are the numbers, this is what we compiled, whatever. And then you'll have like individual thoughts about like who people think are strong and should go where.